So in this lesson, we're going to look more at the sites that are present on an enzyme. Specifically, we're going to add in this addition of an allosteric site, and we're going to distinguish between competitive and non-competitive inhibitors. So when we talk about inhibiting a reaction, we're talking about slowing it down, interfering, or stopping that reaction in some way. And that's the job of an inhibitor. And so we have two types of inhibitors, the first of which are competitive inhibitors. So when we look at our enzyme, what we see at the top here is what we saw initially when we talked about enzymes. We see our enzyme, we see our active site and our substrate, and we notice that the shape of the active site is matching the shape of the substrate. We see our enzyme substrate complex form, and then we see our product. So we see our enzyme has returned, it has not changed, but we see our substrate has been broken into the products. And so this is our normal process. When we look at an inhibited reaction, one that's been slowed down or stopped, what we see is that some molecule, what we call an inhibitor, that there's something similar to its shape, like the substrate. Notice they both have the same shape here at the bottom, but there's something about the rest of the molecule that's different. So this inhibitor comes into the active site, and it sits in here, and it blocks our substrate from coming in. So the reaction that we see in part A simply doesn't happen because there's some other molecule blocking this from happening. Some medications use this model that they inhibit an enzyme and therefore stop, say, a bacteria from growing. So they're stopping that bacteria from reproducing and therefore we're reducing that infection. And so different medications behave in different ways in the body. Not all do this. They all have their own mechanism. But this is one way that we can inhibit that duplication of bacteria and therefore stop an infection. So our inhibitor comes into the active site. So notice again, same shape on both of the species, and then we block the actual substrate from entering and have that reaction from occurring. Now sometimes this is used beneficially when we use medication. Sometimes this is used non-beneficially when we have some foreign species that is inhibiting a critical reaction from occurring. So now what we look at is we're looking at where does the substrate interact with an enzyme. Remember that it happens at the active site because that's where the substrate is always going to interact because it has that shape that's identical to, like our lock and key model, or similar to, like our induced fit model, for that substrate to interact with the enzyme. And that active site is also where a competitive inhibitor will interact with an enzyme. Now we're going to look at a non-competitive inhibitor, and in this case we see it again at the top, our basic reaction, our enzyme reacting with the substrate at the active site, forming our enzyme substrate complex, and then forming the enzyme and the products. Notice there's also a new section or a new site noted on the drawing, which is called the allosteric site. So this is some other site in the molecule. Now all enzymes have these allosteric sites. We haven't pointed them out before because it hasn't been a relevant issue. So we have this allosteric site, which is some place on the molecule which other things can interact that are not the substrate, and they interact with the enzyme in some way. Now, when we look at non-competitive inhibitors, what we see is that this inhibitor, shown here in blue, interacts with the allosteric site. However, by its interaction with the allosteric site, it actually changes the active site. So let's look at the drawing and notice here on our active site step, we see we kind of have basically a pie-shaped piece that is designated as the active site. When this inhibitor interacts with the allosteric site, it has a kind of a ripple effect and changes this active site. Because as this inhibitor interacts with the side chains of the enzymes in our allosteric site, there's an effect that kind of translates over to the active site. Now notice it's not a huge change, but it is a significant change because now that we've changed the shape of the active site, our substrate, which again has the pie shape in it as well, is no longer going to fit in our active site. And it changes it enough that it cannot operate under an induced fit model because it's actually changed it pretty significantly in terms of function. And so now, as long as that non-competitive inhibitor is in that spot, in that allosteric site, our substrate cannot come into the active site. If the non-competitive inhibitor leaves and the active site goes back to its original shape, then our substrate can react. And so this is also another mechanism by which we can control reactions. Again, sometimes beneficially and sometimes not to our benefit. There's one other example what we can see in reactions called self-inhibiting, and this can either fall under the competitive or the non-competitive model. But what we see happening is that we have an enzyme, okay, it's interacting with some substrate. The product of that, which is substrate 2, then interacts with another enzyme. The product of that is substrate 3, which interacts with yet another enzyme and produces our final product. So ultimately, this is what we're trying to form. However, sometimes what we see is that when we're getting too much of product 3 and the reaction needs to slow down, what we can see happening is the presence of multiple substrate 3s, okay, will actually result in inhibition of one of the earlier steps in the process. So we have lots of this substrate 3 because for whatever reason we don't need to produce as much product 3. We're not going to get into the biology of that. But what we see is when we have a lot of the substrate 3, perhaps the body is making it but not using it, that substrate 3 then interacts back with the first enzyme and acts as a non-competitive inhibitor. So the action of this substrate 3, the purple one, interacting at an allosteric site changes something about the active site so that substrate 1 can no longer interact. So this is behaving as a non-competitive inhibitor because we have too much of a product which also can act as an enzyme or an inhibitor. Where does a competitive inhibitor interact with the enzyme? So the competitive inhibitor acts at the active site because it's going to interfere with the substrate interacting with the enzyme.